Hey, CB Murligar from Magic Club. Today's subject is that fake? Yeah, is that fake? Yeah. A lot of people are thinking the coins are fake, like, you know, the coin from 1972, how you can get in mint condition? There were some Travancore coins I posted in group, all in UNC condition, uncirculated condition. Many of the people ask, is that fake? How we can get a coin in such a wonderful condition? How we can get a coin in a UNC condition? And the coin is more than 100 years old. How are you getting in a UNC condition? It's very tough. They don't know how, because many of the people in all over the world, they save the money like an investment. For example, this is a two paisa coin from 1972. It's a 2 paisa coin from 1972. In those days, it's just a 2 paisa. There is nothing more. There is no more value for a 2 paisa. But nowadays, at least you have to pay 5 rupees for a piece. Minimum, you have to pay 5 rupees a piece. Or the people, they don't know about coin industry. They may pay 100 rupees. If you post in OilX or something like that, they will pay 100 rupees. So actually, it was just a 2 paisa. That means a 100 rupee, just a 1 rupee, you can get 50 of this. So you are spending in 1972. Just a 1 rupee, you're getting 50 pieces. And today's market, you just calculate with the 5 rupee a piece, you have 50 pieces. That money, your 1 rupee become 250 rupees. So the people invest in sacks or they invest in lakhs, how much money they can make easily. So that is the market. So the easy things, how the money can get in UNC, the answer is people directly purchase from the bank or where it's available in UNC condition. I'm collecting 5 rupee coin, 10 rupee coin in a mint pack. I'm just keeping aside. I'm not selling, I'm just keeping aside. Maybe after 20 or 30 days, my son is interested in this business, he will sell it. That day, 5 rupee, maybe a 50 rupee a piece. I don't know, I'm not sure, but that what they do in this business. So in 1972, somebody purchased this 2 paisa coin from the bank, and they keep it for a long time. Now they're selling on 5 rupee each. So that's why we're getting in UNC condition. We never get a coin in UNC condition unless it's saving, you know, unless we're keeping in a safe place, or unless we're keeping in a nice packing. The aluminum coins have a problem. If you keep the aluminum coins with any other metals, like any copper or any other metal, the aluminum coin get damaged. That's some chemical things. I don't know about chemical or chemistry. So that kind of some chemical reactions. But if you're keeping like thousands of aluminum coins in a bag, it will never get damaged. You can get it like a same as like this. And nowadays, people getting banknotes from many countries. For this is a Congo banknote. And you know, the new who is in new in this industry, who collecting newly the banknotes, they think these are fake. Once you do an exhibition, you are exhibiting such UNC banknote. The people, the regular people, the normal people, they come to watch your exhibition. They say, oh, it's all photocopy. Because they can believe it. They can believe it. We can get uncirculated pieces. You know, the Congo banknotes was coming in bricks, like thousand pieces. When 2 years back, there was a convention, coin exhibition in Bangalore. The people directly come from Congo and they are selling the UNC banknote. I think a piece for 5 rupees. I think nowadays it's 30 or 40 rupees. They were selling for 5 rupees a piece. So we can get it easily from the bank. That's why we are getting the fresh banknote. This is directly from the bank, not from the circulation. So circulation is also okay, but from the bank we can get the mint condition. I tell you a story. You know, I've been traveled some countries. One time I've been in Jamaica. I've been many times in Jamaica. That was my first time in Jamaica. Every country I go, my first point is the central bank. If we can find a central bank in that city, otherwise I go to the local bank. So in Jamaica, I've been one of their local bank, and they asked for 1 cent coin. 1 cent coin. They're not using 1 cent coin because they stopped in 1980 or something. They stopped the one cent coin. I don't have it here. That means one Jamaican dollar, you can get 100 of Jamaican 1 cent coin. One Jamaican dollar, you get 100 of them. I just keep a calculation here. That means one Jamaican dollar is 51 Indian rupees. One Jamaican dollar is around 51 Indian rupees. So it's like you can get thousands of coins in a 50 rupees or 500 rupees I don't remember, but I still remember, I spend a $10 US dollar, I get a bag of coin. I get a bag of 1 cent coin. I think it's more than 3,000 or 4,000 pieces. It's a full bag of coin from the 1972 or 1977. So the same experience I got it from Curaçao. People said Curaçao, but it's actually say Curaçao. Curaçao is a part of Netherlands Antilles. Netherlands Antilles have two parts. One is Saint Martin. Saint Martin is Netherlands Antilles, part of Netherlands Antilles, and also Curaçao. There's these two parts are controlled by. It was controlled by Dutch, but nowadays it's like it's also controlled. Nowadays it's also controlled by Dutch. So I've been to the Central Bank of Netherlands Antilles. There was an Indian guy. Actually, his family, three generations back, they were Indians. He's working in the bank. So I asked him, can I get some old Curaçao banknote? He said, okay. Because nowadays they're not using the Curaçao separately. They're using Netherlands Antilles dollar. He gave me actually 100 pieces of Curaçao banknote, 100 of them, a bundle, just for the exchange rate. That means I spent, I think it's 38 rupees for one Curaçao banknote. Nobody believe in numismatic industry because Curaçao banknote is costing minimum 1,000 to 2,000 rupees. That's depend on the condition. But this one, it's cost me only 38 rupees as an exchange rate. He also gave me a lot of Curaçao coins on exchange rate. So that is my experience, how I get Curaçao banknote. Same experience I had from Antigua. I got an old Antiguan banknote in full bundle, just a UNC bundle, just for the exchange rate. Also, you can see, this is a 1 cent from East Caribbean state. East Caribbean state 1 cent. This is also I got in packs, big packs, like 3,000, 5,000 coins, aluminium coins, for an exchange rate of, I think, $10 or something. So this is the way how we get coin in fresh condition. People are investing such coins. See, I have such coins in 1 paise, 2 paise, 5 paise, in 1,000 pieces. I'm not selling. I'm just keeping. Still, I told you, this 2 paise become today's market is 5 rupee. Maybe after 10 or 20 years, it's maybe 50 rupee. We don't know. But still, it's in UNC condition. That's where we're getting UNC condition. Don't think it's fake. But there is a lot of fake also. I tell you how. This is not a fake. But there is a lot of fake names. Like country like Palestine. Palestine issued banknote in 1926 or something like that. Panama is the same. But they newly make the banknotes of the rare country's name. Like Palestine, Panama, Danish West Indies, etc., etc. That's all are fake. If you have a printer, you can print it out. That's it. So before you buying, just study about the country. Study about the banknotes. Study about the coin. Make sure the country issued such things. Then you can buy it. So that's where we're getting fresh banknotes. It's always getting from the bank. Otherwise, we can get it in, you know, unfold size. It's a UNC piece. This is the way how we know it's a wonderful piece. You can put it in your hand and make sure it's a good one. So that's it for today. Enjoy. Keep watching.